Now, James Packer has sold almost half of his stake in Crown Resorts in a deal worth close to $2 billion. The sale comes after merger talks with American casino giant Wynn broke down. Our finance editor, Ross Greenwood, joins us now. Ross, a lot of money on the table here. What does it mean for the future of the entire Packer empire?
Well, it's really interesting to watch James Packer. James Packer, of course, you know, has stood down from the board of Crown, range of different things over the past year or so. He's obviously had his battles with mental health. There's no doubt about that. James Packer prides two things above all others. One is his privacy, and that's one of the reasons why he's withdrawn from Australia. Number two is he is really averse to debt, and particularly after he settled with his sister Gretel in the estate of Kerry Packer, it was a situation where he took on significant amounts of debt. He was never happy about that. Now, bear in mind that it's only 6 to 7 weeks ago that a takeover bid for all of Crown apparently landed on the table from the US casino giant Wynn. Now, that particular deal fell apart after it was leaked prematurely.
Spectacularly fell apart.
And so what's happened is James Packer now has gone to his former partner in those Macau casinos that he walked away from. So that is Lawrence Ho. You can see here a photograph that I took at the launch of the Studio City Casino in Macau. And that only goes back to 2016. But since then, basically, Packer has walked away. So this deal now brings down his stake from 46% to 26%. In the meantime, then one of the largest casino operators in the world, Lawrence Ho from Melco, takes a 20% stake in Crown. Be interesting to watch it.
Absolutely. Ross Greenwood with the very latest. Thank you.